Sahi, I know you like to solve puzzles. Let me ask you some.
Yes, Didi, please ask.
Which one should I ask? Okay, let's start with a simple one.
Yes, tell me.
Take these 10 toffees. Suppose two of your friends are coming here to meet you. Then, can you distribute these 10 toffees among the two of them equally?
Yes, look here. I will start giving each one of them one toffee, and when both get 5 toffees, I would have been finished with all the 10 toffees.
Good, you are right.
But Didi, I did not like this.
Why, Sai? What did you not like?
You told me to distribute all the toffees. What about me? Should I have no toffees?
Okay, if I tell you to distribute these 10 toffees among the three of you, then?
Yes, this is good. Each one will get 3 toffees, but one toffee will remain.
Right, that means you cannot distribute 10 toffees among 3 people without breaking any of them. Sai, among how many people can you distribute these toffees equally? Can you tell me?
Wait Didi, I will tell you. If there are 4 persons, each one will get 2 toffees. But 2 fours are 8. So only 8 toffees will finish and 2 will remain. If there are 5 persons, then each one will get 2 and all toffees will finish. That means we cannot distribute 10 toffees equally among 4 persons. But we can do it among 5 persons. Yes, I understand now. If 10 is divisible completely by the number of persons, that is 2, 5 or 10, then it is possible. Right, Didi?
Right, but you forgot one thing. What if none of your friends come to meet you? You will get all the toffees then. That means 10 toffees can be distributed among one person also.
Yes, Didi, understood. If you give me 11 toffees instead of 10, then they can be distributed only among 11 persons or just one person. This is because 11 is not divisible by any other number.
Good. Now we understood this surely. Now I will ask you another riddle. This is a little more difficult than the previous one. Will you solve it? Should I ask you?
Yes, I will solve it. You tell me the riddle.
Listen carefully. Suppose instead of giving you 10 toffees, I give you a bag full of either 10 or 12 toffees. Then, among how many people can you distribute all the toffees equally?
That's easy. If you give me a bag full of 10 toffees, then I can distribute it equally among 1, 2, 5 or 10 persons. If you give me 12 toffees, all the numbers which can divide 12, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12 persons will get equal number of toffees. Right, Didi?
Sai, you have not given the answer to this riddle yet.
Oh, Didi, what did I do wrong? I exactly did the same thing what I did in the last riddle.
No, nothing is wrong. But you did not solve the riddle completely. Remember one thing. In this riddle, you do not know the exact number of toffees in the bag. If you know that there are 10 toffees in the bag, your first answer is correct. But only if you know that there are 12 toffees in the bag, your second answer is correct. Understand?
Understood. But Didi, what should I do? I don't know the number of toffees and I also don't know the number of persons I have to divide the toffees among.
Think, Sai. You know the answer if you know how many toffees are there in the bag. But here, you don't know the exact number of toffees in the bag. So, to find out the number of people, you first have to find out a number which will be correct for both 10 or 12 toffees.
Got it. I should find out a number of children among which 10 toffees can be distributed equally and also 12 toffees can be distributed equally. We found out that for 10 toffees, 1, 2, 5 or 10 children and for 12 toffees, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 or 12 children. So, 1 and 2 are common for 10 and 12 toffees. That means all the toffees from the bag, we don't know 10 or 12, can be distributed equally among 1 or 2 persons. Is that right, Didi?
Right. Now, you tell me, if there are 12 or 16 toffees in the bag, among how many people can you distribute them equally?
Yes, I will tell you. We can distribute 12 toffees among 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 or 12 persons and 16 toffees among numbers that can divide 16, which means 1, 2, 4, 8 or 16 persons. That means all toffees from the bag can be distributed among 1, 2 or 4 persons equally.
Nice thing. Did you realize one thing? Whatever the number of toffees there are in the bag, they could all be given to you or could be distributed equally among one person. Similarly, the number of toffees which could be distributed equally among four people can also be distributed equally among two people. But the total number of toffees is the same. Therefore, the number of toffees distributed equally among two people would be double the number of toffees distributed among four people. For example, if there are 12 toffees, four people would get 3 toffees each, but two people would get 6 toffees each.
Yes, Didi, I understood.
The largest number among which the toffees in the bag could be distributed is known as the greatest common divisor or GCD of the numbers, which for 12 and 16 is 4. Now you tell me, among how many maximum number of people can you distribute 6, 9 or 12 toffees?
To distribute the given number of toffees among maximum persons, we have to find the GCD of the numbers 6, 9 and 12. That means I have to find the largest number that can completely divide the numbers 6, 9 and 12. If I write such numbers for 6, 1, 2, 3 and 6, for 9, 1, 3 and 9, for 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. Therefore, GCD is 3.
Good. Now you are able to find out the GCD for given numbers. Now, I will ask you a fun puzzle. You have to find out how can you use GCD in this puzzle as well.
Okay, ask me.
When the construction of our house was going on, my father had asked me this question. I must have been your age then. Our drawing room is 12 feet long and 10 feet wide. They were planning to put tiles with beautiful designs for that room. My father had asked me, if we decide to fix same size and square shaped tiles, what maximum size of each tile can we use? Let us see if we can solve this.
Wait, Didi, we want to use square shaped tiles. So the length and breadth of the tiles will be the same. But the room, it is not in the square shape. Its length is 12 and breadth is 10. So we require such length of tiles with which we will be able to make both 10 feet and 12 feet. That means we must find numbers which can divide both 10 and 12 completely. If you want tiles with maximum size, we must find the largest number which can divide 10 and 12. That is the GCD. Numbers that can divide 10 are 1, 2, 5 and 10. Numbers that can divide 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. Thus, GCD of 10 and 12 is 2. That means we can use maximum 2 feet long and broad tiles. Right, Didi?
Right, Sai. You answered perfectly.